Next on KIRO 7 Eyewitness News, Profiles. He plays guitar for one of the world's most popular rock bands, Pearl Jam. But Mike McCready has another calling, helping people live with a debilitating disease, a disease that he has himself.
It's almost like being in your own torture chamber. Your body is torturing you when you have Crohn's or colitis disease.
So you want to be a rock and roll star? Be aware of the price you'll pay for fame and glory.
Pearl Jam's Mike McCready knows that all too well. For nearly two decades, the 41-year-old Seattle musician has learned a lot about the ups and downs of rock and roll life. As Amy Clancy discovered, at times, the journey has left him fighting for his life.
He plays guitar for one of the world's most popular bands. In the early 90s, Seattle's Pearl Jam stormed the rock scene with a searing sound. It's a sound that has stood the test of time. On lead guitar, Mike McCready. On stage, McCready has been known to play with a passion that borders on reckless abandon. But in real life, his demeanor is strikingly different.
As a musician and as an artist, you want the majority, you want people to hear it. And if you're lucky, as we were, you can hopefully make a living out of it, too.
McCready has made more than a living at it. During the past 17 years, Pearl Jam has sold a whopping 70 million albums. But the road to success has had its share of potholes, especially for McCready. When he's just 11 years old, McCready picks up his first guitar.
It started out, I was in the Cub Scouts. Fully with the outfit and the hat and all the stuff and way into it and doing all that. Then one day I heard the rock band Kiss, and it was Cub Scouts to Kiss. And I was like, I think I want to play music.
McCready forms a band with neighborhood friends. He keeps playing guitar through his high school years. After graduating from Roosevelt High in Seattle, McCready takes his band Shadow to Los Angeles in search of fame and fortune.
It was a tough time, and we were starving and eating top ramen, and the landscape that was Los Angeles, that there was 10,000 or plus bands down there, that the odds of a band making it are very small. And I guess my parents' voice, it was in the back of my head going, you have to have something to fall back on. And
thoroughly disillusioned with the music scene, McCready moves back to Seattle, enrolls in college, and gives up playing guitar. But after attending a Stevie Ray Vaughan concert at the Gorge in 1988, McCready is inspired to start again. Then one night at a house party, his life is forever changed. Another Seattle guitarist, Stone Gossard, hears McCready jamming along with a record in a back room. He's impressed. 3 months later, he asks McCready to join a few other musicians who are trying to form a new band. Within a matter of months, that band becomes Pearl Jam.
Everything was working, everything was firing, all neurons. Every guy's really good in the band, and it just felt right, and it was exciting.
Soon after the release of its first album in 1991, Pearl Jam's popularity soars. Its meteoric rise to the upper tier of rock far exceeds anyone's expectations. Pearl Jam finds itself sitting on top of a Seattle music scene that attracts international attention. A music scene labeled grunge.
We had no idea. We thought, well, you know, we'll go out and tour. And we went over to the East Coast, and we were in a band, and then they built rather quickly from there.
Soon McCready finds himself drowning in the fame and fortune he once searched for. At times, it's overwhelming.
You know, people just following us around or trying to get our numbers or all the stuff that goes along with fame that sucks. That being said, it's a double-edged sword. You want to achieve success. All your dreams come true and all your nightmares come true at the same time. People are starting to recognize me, and that's kind of freaking me out a little bit.
The emotions come to a head at rock festivals where Pearl Jam shares the bill with other bands.
We'd come on and there would be 30,000 people that would rush to the stage. Not literally 20 to 30, like chairs flying and And then we get off, and they disperse, and the next band, and they kind of watch them. And the same, so we were like, what is going on here? It gets weird. Fame is a weird thing. We all dealt with it in different ways. I think I partied way too hard. That's how I dealt with it.
By the mid-90s, as Pearl Jam begins rehearsing for its third album, McCready hits the wall.
I hit it hard. I was drinking hard. I was doing all the, I was living the rock star lifestyle, doing the excesses and the partying and the drugs and the drinking and all of that, to the point of just oblivion. And it was ruining my life. And, you know, at that time, I decided to get, you know, I went into rehab and I got clean and sober.
It is another pivotal moment in the life and career of Mike McCready.
I was waking up and I was learning how to live again. I was smelling flowers and seeing sunsets and writing songs and talking and being nervous and scared, and you know, all of these new emotions were coming out, and I was learning them and feeling them sometimes for the first time.
McCready continues to tour and make music with Pearl Jam. In total, the band records 8 studio albums and releases nearly 200 live bootleg albums. Pearl Jam sustains its popularity for 17 years. It is a band destined for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. During this entire roller coaster ride, McCready lives with a secret, another personal battle, Crohn's disease, a debilitating inflammatory condition that affects the gastrointestinal tract.
Basically, it feels like a knife in your gut, and there's no holding it back. You don't have the control. And it sucks. It hurts. You're bleeding. You become anemic. There's all sorts of other complications that can come with it. I was very silent about it for a long time, though. I was very ashamed of it. I was very much in denial of it. I wouldn't follow doctor's orders. I would just kind of like, oh, it'll just go away, you know, super denial, super shamefulness. Oh, I don't want to talk about it because I'm basically having an accident in my pants and I don't want anybody to know because I'm this cool rock star in my mind. But that's just all a bunch of ego and stupid.
McCready's decision to go public goes beyond brave talk. Tonight, he is rehearsing with a group of friends for his 5th annual benefit concert, supporting the Northwest chapter of the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation. The benefit will raise money for kids in the Northwest who suffer from Crohn's disease. Daniel Johnston of Port Angeles is one of them. He met McCready at a Paul Newman camp in Los Angeles for kids with Crohn's disease and colitis.
It was one of the greatest experiences I've ever been part of because I got to see a ton of other people that have had the same disease that I have, albeit younger, but working in a positive way along with counselors and doctors and people in this organization, and to just better their lives or just have a good time together. These are things that we had at a show years ago.
McCready never seems to tire when it comes to giving fans like Daniel a tour of the band's Costco-sized warehouse full of guitars, drums, and Pearl Jam paraphernalia.
Those are some monkeys I used to put on my amp right there. Yeah, this is where it all goes on. That'll work on you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Work great.
It's well documented that I'm stealing my own stuff.
The attention means a lot to Daniel Johnston.
This is absolutely insane. It's awesome to be here. this is crazy. I love it. It's really incredible just to see someone who's been through so much more than I have, and yet at the same time who's living with the same problem that I have. He's accomplished so much in his life, and it really pushes me to go as far as I can with whatever I want to do.
To McCready, it's more than just playing guitar, making a lot of money, and performing in front of enthusiastic crowds every night. He wants to make a difference with his talent, which is what this benefit here at the Showbox Theater is all about. Lights out! Lights out!
She's tearing paranoid! McCready and friends play before a packed house at the Showbox and raise thousands of dollars for the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation. To McCready, that's just as important as playing in one of the world's most popular bands.
If you have some sort of fame and some sort of notoriety, that if you can put that to a good use in the greater populace or whatever, that you should do that. Because why not? Why not do a positive thing? Why not raise awareness to a disease or a cause or anything? Because that's what life's about, is hopefully trying to better each other in their situations. You know, let's make our lives get better and go higher.
From Cub Scouts to Pearl Jam to playing benefits for a worthy cause, there are days when this life all seems like a dream to Mike McCready. A really nice dream.
I get to do what I've always wanted to do, and I'm very grateful for that. And yeah, I think about that almost daily and think, wow, how did it happen? It happened. I'm stoked about it. It just makes me grateful to be alive.
Life is pretty full these days for Mike McCready. He's offering his support for the annual Crohn's and Colitis Foundation luncheon this Friday at the Sheraton Hotel in Seattle. This June, he'll be touring with Pearl Jam in Europe. And he and his wife are expecting their first child, a baby girl, any day now.